That's a very good and simple question. Number one, to afford them, you have to, does what I want to borrow money for, does it really worth it? If what you want to borrow money for, it doesn't worth it, then you can avoid debt. Make sure you have, you know, before you borrow, make sure you have the job security that is going to invest you the money to pay back. The source of payment, you have to know that the money you want to borrow, you have source that is coming to pay back. Because that is how you're going to avoid debt. To make sure that what you really want to do doesn't really to borrow. Like I said, people that use money to do party, borrow money to do party, out of the way. You don't just want to do that. You can borrow money if you want to invest, you want to do business, you want to go to school. Yes, it's an investment. Go to school, going to school is an investment. Okay? So, you have to borrow. And then, if you are going to school, you have to, the before you started paying, they already give you that after you have graduated, you know, after you are graduated, sometimes they give them 6 months.
No interest.
Yeah. So before they start, after they graduated, before they started paying. So, but if you have your money, then you can pay. Or, especially for students, all our kids in Pentecost ministry, I want them to be on scholarship. God will do it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So, if you are very good in your academic, you will have scholarship. There are a lot of programs of scholarship, but they give to the people that are academically good. But if you have to borrow to go to school, fine. If you have to borrow money to do business, fine. If you have to borrow money to buy tools, fine. If you have to borrow money to buy house, fine. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I used to borrow money to buy house before God blessed me. And I can pay cash to buy a house. Now, you can borrow money to buy a car, okay? You can borrow money to buy, you know, whatever. So, but avoid it. Do everything to avoid it if you know that what you want to do it is not necessary. That is all about. That is what we are talking now about here because we don't want to put ourselves into trouble. Hello? People on the phone, you also can agree with me that it is easy for you to borrow. It's easy for people to borrow. When you want to borrow, borrow me. But to pay back is not as easy if you don't have the income and the source of that payment. So don't borrow. And I pray the Almighty God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now, as a pastor, now this is my experience, is that I don't like to borrow church member money. I do not like it because if you laugh when you borrow anybody money, either church member or no church member, but people, if a pastor borrow church member money, it's a way of asking the person to leave the church. When you laugh too much, they may say you are laughing about them. When you frank your face, they may say you frank about them. And I believe that applies to anybody. So, because what is in the mind of the people that own you, they don't know what they're trying to, if they can pay, I mean, if people that can pay, they will not, you know, attach anything. But people that doesn't want to pay, they will try to find excuse for their inability to pay. So, that is why it's not encouraged for you to borrow, for a pastor to borrow the members' money. But there are people that you still have to borrow or you have to give if they are in need. There's nothing wrong about that for you to borrow. In fact, the Bible says we shall be a lender and not the borrower. There's nothing wrong. It's not a sin for you to do that, but it's not encouraged. Because with experience, some people borrow, they will not pay. Some people we actually, you know, use that excuse to, you know, to actually run away. I pray the Almighty God will help us in Jesus' name.